Love him, hate him, Ricky Gutierrez has got to be the most popular day trader on the YouTube platform. With a subscriber count over a milli and over 80 million channel views, the numbers don't lie. There's a couple day trading channels with 700,000-800,000 subscribers, but Ricky got the M-ball. Now, what makes this interesting is that he's also probably one of the most controversial day traders on the platform. There's been dozens of expose-style videos created in regards to him where people seem to have a lot of issues. Now, does this just come with being the biggest in the space, or do these accusations hold some merit? I want to dive in, investigate, and ultimately infiltrate his headquarters in order to confront the biggest day trader on YouTube, Ricky Gutierrez. I mean, if someone has a million followers on Instagram, it doesn't really mean much. I could go and buy that with the press of a button right now. But YouTube is different. People don't really successfully buy YouTube subscribers. It usually takes years of hard work and effort to get to much less than where Ricky's at right now. So how does Mr. Gutierrez have a loyal following of over 1 million people on one side and a ton of not even skeptics, but straight up haters and doubters on the other? I want to find out the truth, or at least get a better perspective on it and just the overall day trading space as a whole, because I don't think I've ever personally talked to a day trader in real life. If you don't know him, he apparently started his entrepreneurship journey outside of YouTube by flipping cars, working in sales, and I think he even did some house hacking or house flipping. It seems like he was doing okay even before he started his personal brand, but eventually he got on YouTube to talk about his different ventures, but people were most interested in his stock market and day trading type videos. So he ran with that, and now over 6 years later, he has over 1,000 videos on his channel with over 1 million subscribers. There's been a couple major hit pieces, if you will, made on Ricky, to which I don't think I've seen any rebuttals from him. There was the Andrew Hales interview that he kind of caught some slack for. Then CoffeeZilla made a full video about him, and both of these views alone have over 1 million views each. And then there's a bunch of videos that kind of followed suit and hopped on this bandwagon. So I shot him a DM on Instagram saying, hey, if I fly down to Arizona, would you be willing to go on camera and elaborate on some of these accusations that people have made about you? I didn't want this to be an unexpected hit piece or some gotcha journalism type thing where I pull up asking him for an interview and then I come out with all of these questions out of left field. So I actually gave him a heads up that I want to specifically ask about these uncomfortable topics. To my surprise, he was completely down. So tomorrow we're going to wake up at like 4 a.m. and fly down to Phoenix for a couple hours to meet the man himself.
I like
action,
it.
Baby.
Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Ricky Gutierrez.
And you've had some controversial moments throughout your career as a public figure. In 2018.
Public figure, yes.
Well, I mean, I feel like that's a fair title. But in 2018, you did an interview with YouTube legend Andrew Hales.
Yep.
That received kind of a mixed reaction.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Ricky.
Yeah.
In three sentences or less, if you're a millionaire, why sell a course?
Okay.
Would you say that was kind of when the Ricky Gutierrez brand started coming under scrutiny, or was there some backlash right from the get-go from when you initially started making videos?
Not from when, I mean, no one makes videos or there's no scrutiny over anyone that no one knows, right? During that time, 2018, I was popping off. It made sense on why that video gained a lot of traction. I actually filmed for an hour and a half, and I think the interview was only 20, 30 minutes. That's why I asked you how long it was going to be, because I got asked that question and I answered it in a very straightforward way where, you know, why does anyone sell anything? It's of course to make money and there's no question about it. But at the end of the day, if I film for an hour and a half and only 20, 30 minutes of that content gets used, you can tell that, I mean, there is an intent in the way that the video wanted to be guided, which was kind of my question to you. It's like, you know, as you're filming this video, like you have the option to be able to guide it in any direction to make it the most, you know, like, oh, this would actually be really good to include. I don't know if I'm going to include that.
Okay. So would you say that Andrew Hales did you dirty a little bit? Was there more to it?
It was one of my first times ever signing a paperwork where I'm pretty much releasing liability of the thing where I was like, okay, I'm not doing that again.
I should have thought of that.
No, but I took it as a lesson learned. I mean, if you were to show the entire interview, I asked him specific questions of like, I used to watch that dude all the time. I loved watching his YouTube videos, the prank videos, right? And I was like, Andrew, like, I mean, he used me as a millionaire, which is a milestone for people, but even making six figures, right, is a milestone itself. I asked him, I was like, you've made six figures, no question about it. Why do you still film videos? To make money. I didn't think that was like, like, how is that? Why does anyone do anything? Why does someone go to work? It's common sense, right? I value my time. It would be the same question for you. Why do you sell the service when you've already done well? Why does Andrew continue to film videos if he's already done well?
I have a rebuttal to that.
Let me hear it.
So with a business, like, I don't want to be biased here and talk about dropshipping.
No, of course.
But it's what I know. So I'll reference dropshipping.
Of course.
With dropshipping, in order for me to get to like $100 million e-com business, right? That's going to require me to have a lot of friction with scaling. I'm gonna need warehouses, I'm gonna need employees. But with day trading, if you have a strategy that works, couldn't you infinitely just with a snap of your fingers scale that up? Just if you compound your money?
I might perform very well trading with $50,000, but trading with $1 million, and if something were to pull back, I might hesitate. I might not be as effective at that same type of dollar value.
Giving back into the juice here, a year after the Andrew Hales interview, CoffeeZilla, this was before he had the $10 million studio. He was just starting out with his humble voiceovers, but he did a video on you. I think you were like the second or third video he's ever done.
I think I was pretty early on.
Yeah, but he straight up accused you of being a scammer. And that whole accusation centered around the fact that you made it a realistic goal to hit 2% profit per day.
Scam people out of their money. Because that, make no mistake, that is what Ricky Gutierrez is doing. He just said a 1 to 1.5% goal is a realistic benchmark for one of his students to hit when they're starting out. Ricky says that's conservative. I would say that's insane and impossible. That is an annualized return of 365%.
Goal on a weekly basis is 10 to 15%. And I've been doing this for years.
I can tell you straight up, if that was true, the world's largest investment banks and hedge funds and stock exchanges would be running after this guy so he can make them money. Those results are simply ridiculous.
Do you stand by that goal? Do you want to elaborate on that?
And it goes back to only showing the narrative of what they want to. And no, he won't plug that video, because if you watch that video, people are asking, how can you hit a specific milestone? And I said, just the way that you can hit anything, you can set a goal. And I give the example of 2%, and I clearly label that, you know, 2% is a number that I come up with. You can create a 2% for a week, 2% for a month. The number is relative to whatever you want to set for yourself. But I did not understand why something that was set as a goal was something that was frowned upon. When I saw that video, and then a couple comments started calling him out for like the discrepancy in his percentage, the discrepancy of people were like, no, like he said that was a goal. The comments are no longer there.
But can you see how it could be perceived as slightly deceptive if you put out this goal of, oh, the goal is to make 2% per day, and you advertise your program with that goal?
Of advertising or the 2% a day, in that video, I talk about and encourage them to set your own goal. This was the goal that I set. So that's the thing. It's like that side wasn't even shown, because it wasn't, hey, this is how you make 2% a day. I showed how to work towards making two. Like, when was having a goal or having something to work towards something that should be frowned upon?
Sure, but do you think it's reasonable, and it's a reasonable goal to hit 2% profit per day?
No, well, it was a goal. As in,
but
like,
is that a reasonable goal?
No, it's aggressive for sure. No question about it.
Mm-hmm.
People said, I mean, the 2% a day is one thing, right? But we've also seen a lot of lower cap stocks shoot 500, 200, the whole AMC movement. And those are the ones that are very highly, you know, there's a lot of attention behind those, right? There's runners every single day that are running 50, 100%.
But I mean, historically, something like even doing 1% per day profit, that's somewhat unrealistic consistently, right?
Correct. That's if you trade every single day. There's no, I mean, do you think if I thought that you can make 1% a day or 2% a day, any of that, I would have such a big focus on risk management? That's why we have risk to reward ratios.
I'm not saying he had to or he's obliged to, but did Coffee at any point reach out to? Because the video's at 1 million views, it's kind of a big deal.
Was there no communication
before or after?
Not that I know of. I do not know. I didn't reach out to him. I saw the video the couple of times, and I saw people sending me that like, oh, I responded to this and my comment got blocked. Other than that, there was just so many ways that I could have responded to it. I just wanted, I don't want to call it the higher road, but I understood that I had the people were waiting for that attention. But on top of that, I knew that I could fuel people potentially back, and I just didn't want to do that.
But if you have such a good response and you could clap back in a, like a way that where you come out on top, I mean, that would be great for all the numbers on your channel. Why not do it?
I don't think so.
And why not show the people the truth?
It's not about, I mean, what truth? He showed nothing. That's the part, like, there was no fact, there was no truth. His numbers were wrong. He didn't show my whole video. There was no truth in what he said. There's no facts or, hey, he did this. It's, I don't believe him, or no, you can't do this, or.
But I mean, to be fair, like, I don't mean to keep coming back to this, but you can't do 2% per day consistently.
Correct. I didn't say that you can do it consistently. That's the thing. It's, I said in that video, I had a goal of 2%. It's not that I hit it consistently, right? It's not that anyone can hit it consistently. That's not what a goal is. A goal isn't guaranteed. It's something to work towards. There's like this like little riddle or message of people hate in what they can't conquer. When someone can't potentially afford a Ferrari and they know that about themselves, then all they resort to is hate. It's very easy to judge someone because it makes you almost just okay with the position that you are in life. I've never been that way. Anytime that I see someone doing well, I love it. When I see how young you were when I first heard of you and how well you were doing, it empowered me. It puts things into perspective for me of what's possible. And I think that just says a lot about someone's character, that if what you resort to is judging people right away just because they're slightly doing better or you don't agree with what they're doing, then it's so much time is lost in that never-ending pursuit of fulfillment and filling that void.
Well, and there's also the financial aspect to it. These exposing Ricky Gutierrez videos, crazy AdSense. And I mean, here there are no heroes, guys. What are we doing here? You know,
it's
they get views.
Everyone
and they
that
get money.
Pitches their or that has ever made that video, look at it. It's they have their own intent with it, and I understand it. I understand it to a point where like. Now, I mean, I have lawyers in place and stuff like that. Like, there's a reason why we are where we are now. It's like your pockets better be deep if you have specific things that you want to say, and you better have proof. Because if there's any form of defamation of character, then, I mean, we have the systems in place now.
So, I mean, those are pretty much the only accusations I wanted to confront you with. Do you have anything else you want to rebuttal or anything like that?
No, it's, I mean, I have nothing that I wanted to originally rebuttal. I mean, I'm grateful that, I guess, you valued this enough to fly out here in such a short time. I'm glad that I was able to show you the HQ, and my job is not to be perfect because I'm not perfect. My job is to try to just be the best version of myself, and I'm very happy that I'm able to, you know, work towards that.
Okay, so disclaimer, this was about a 1 hour interview I cut down to just show the meat. I believe I did it in an honest, fair way that properly conveyed Ricky's responses and rebuttals. I personally have some thoughts after conducting this interview, but I don't want my opinion on Mr. Gutierrez or the day trading space overall to sway anybody else's. I simply wanted to dive deeper and provide this unbiased piece of content, but I'm incredibly curious to hear your guys' thoughts after watching this video, so please do leave those in the comment section below. Hope you enjoyed this video and have an amazing rest of your day. Peace.